Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it looks like it's about that time to dive into another tiny Stadt in Deutschland. Today we're going to be diving into Mainz. Not Mainz, but Mainz. Mainz, Germany. If you guys are new to the channel, welcome. If you guys are returning viewers, welcome back. We post videos every single day. And we haven't done a deep dive in a long time. So let's go back to doing our deep dives. If you have any other cities you want me to check out, go ahead and let me know in the comments down below. But today we're going to be taking a huge dive into Mainz and see what makes Mainz so special. I'm curious because while I plan my trip to Germany, I want to get a full rundown of each individual city that's out there, big and small. So let's not waste any time. Go ahead and subscribe if you're new. And if you guys have any tips or if you guys are from this area, let me know. Let's check this out and see what we can find out. Los geht's. So from what we can see here, we have this little blurb. We always read this off. Mainz is a German city on the Rhine River. It's known for its old town with half-timbered houses and medieval market squares. In the center, the Markbrunnen is a Renaissance fountain with red columns. Nearby, a distinctive octagonal tower tops the Romanesque Mainz Cathedral, built of deep red sandstone. The Gutenberg Museum honors the inventor of the printing press with exhibits, including two of his original Bibles. He made two Bibles? Oh my God. So currently it's 26 degrees Celsius, which is decent. You know what I mean? Like, it's better there than it is here. I don't really like the heat too much. And I don't know. Wow. A 3-star hotel in Mainz costs 84 euro. Interesting. Things to do. We'll get into that a little bit later. But maybe we could get like a brief rundown of some history. Let's go to Wikipedia. It'll probably tell us everything we need to know. Okay. Welcher Fluss is in Mainz? So is it which river is in Mainz? Die Hessische und die Rheinland-Pfalzische Landhauptstädte Wiesbaden und Mainz trennt nur ein Fluss. Der Rhein. Oh, the Rhine River. Okay, so basically, the Rhine River goes through Mainz. Now, let's go look at Wikipedia and see what it has. Awesome! Let's read this wonderful slice of history from Mainz, right? Alright, so Mainz is the capital of the largest city, Rhineland-Palatinate, Germany. Most of the city is upstream of the Rhine before it flows west. The north of the city faces Wiesbaden, the capital of the neighboring state Hesse. And the east, the confluence of the Main. Whoa, that's a really weird sentence right there. Anyways, Mainz is an independent city with a population of 218,000 people, basically, and forms part of the Frankfurt-Rhine-Main metropolitan region. Mainz was founded by the Romans in the 1st century BC as a military fortress on the northernmost frontier of the empire and provincial capital of Germania Superior. Oh, wow. Mainz also became an important city in the 8th century AD as a part of the Holy Roman Empire, capital of the Electorate of Mainz and the seat of the Archbishop Elector of Mainz, the Primate of Germany. Mainz is famous as the birthplace of Johannes Gutenberg, the inventor of the movable type printing press, who in the early 1450s manufactured his first books in the city, including the Gutenberg Bible. Mainz was heavily damaged in World War II. More than 30 air raids destroyed most of the historic buildings, and Mainz is also notable as a transport hub for wine production and for many rebuilt historic buildings. Interesting. That actually seems pretty dope. So wine, historic buildings. I mean, what more can you ask for? Let's go ahead and look through here. What are common questions do people ask about this? So was für ein Fluss fließt durch Wiesbaden? Once again, what river flows through Wiesbaden? Dog, the Rhineland River. Jesus Christ, the Rhine. Anyways, let's look at the images over here. And then we'll look at things to do. There's a things to do thing down there, so we'll check that out. Oh my God. If you ever wanted to make sweet love to an image, well, now's your chance, because this right here, it's time to bust a fat one. A fat one. Bust out your napkins and some lotion, y'all, because mine's look like a dream come true. Wow. Oh my God. Look at that. Look at that beauty. Look at that beauty. Oh my God. You have a nice clash of modernesque infrastructure with some old classic historical architecture. It's tight. I like it. It's dope. You have, like, you know, this little thing here. Oh, look at this. This is cute. Look at that. How could you hate it, man? We love to see it. We love to see it. Landhauptstadt Wiesbaden. Yo, Wiesbaden be looking kind of sexy, though. I ain't gonna hold you, my guy. Looking kind of nice. Like, this high key looks like a place I want to visit. Now, I do have a few questions of my own that only people from Germany could probably answer, because y'all live out there. In Mainz, how are the people? Are the people friendly? Is it like a super conservative area, super liberal area? Is it tourist friendly? Is it not tourist friendly? These are things that I would like to know the answers to, because I have no idea. I'm not trying to get caught lacking out there, you know what I mean? Because it does look kind of nice, but, you know, I'm not trying to walk out there and have somebody walk up to me and try to steal all my coins, you know what I'm saying? But I highly doubt that'll happen. But you know what I mean? Like, there's just friendly places and not so friendly places. I'm wondering if this is a place that's friendly. I feel like part of what makes the experience a good experience is the encounters in foreign countries. I remember my friend telling me Slovakia was one of the worst places he's ever been in his entire life. Slovakia, he said, was complete trash, like garbage. Like, he got treated horribly out there. In fact, if story time, he said basically he went backpacking through Europe, right? He said the worst place to go backpacking in Europe was Slovakia. And he said that the people hated, if they found out that you're American, they would intentionally, like, not help you, or they would intentionally give you, like, really bad directions and stuff like that, and just made the time there really rough. But he said the best place to go backpacking was definitely, hands down, Germany. And, you know, he said the people were really friendly, very helpful. The place was absolutely beautiful. The quality of the food was God tier. Like, I mean, y'all did it big. So that story right there made me want to go even more. So yeah, I'm just curious. I feel like the people add to the experience of what you encounter in a place you've never been to before. I mean, it's like somebody visiting America and, you know, everybody in America just being dicks. You know what I'm saying? Like, America itself might be nice, but then when you talk to the people, you're just like, ew, gross. So, yeah, I don't know if that made any sense, but y'all let me know in the comments down below if y'all fucking with it or not. Yo, this right here, though, the architecture here, man, I want to shed a tear, because look how beautiful this is. Hotel Mainz? Oh, you best believe. Lage und Umgebung. Yo, this look dope, man. I'm not going to lie. This looks very magical. I know magical is not a word people would use to describe very many things, but I would say this right here is simply breathtaking. If I was out there vlogging right now, woo, we would be turned up. We would be turned up. I would have so much built up excitement. I already have built up excitement. So, I mean, I would just be, ooh, man, it's on my Donkey Kong. You know what I'm saying? Look at this. Look at this. Imagine this whole village. Looks like the Christmas markets I used to see that people would literally build from scratch in, like, Chicago and stuff. Because obviously the Christmas markets in Chicago were trying to replicate the German Christmas market. So this right here, bro, oh my God, dog. Oh my God. And look, this is what it looks like during the day, bro. Oh my God, dude. Oh my God. Mainz Tourismus, Old City Center, Touring Mainz. I need to see what y'all got out there, man, because now I'm actually curious. This is crazy, bro. Y'all definitely have, like, a lot to do in Mainz, for show. So let me go check out things to do in Mainz. All right, that's what we want. Gutenberg Museum. Ooh, Gutenberg, you know what I mean? That looks nice. All right, so let's say the Gutenberg Museum is one of the oldest museums of printing. In the world. Located opposite of the cathedral in the old part of Mainz, Germany, it is named after Johannes Gutenberg, the inventor of printing from the movable metal type in Western Europe. The collections include printing equipment and examples of printing Whoa, whoa, whoa. The collections include printing equipment and examples of printed materials from many cultures. This right here is beautiful. Beautiful. I want to print out something. I want to see if they'll let me print something out over here. I'm like, hey, this is the original Kinko's, man. And in case y'all don't know what Kinko's is, for dolls, people out there that have never seen Kinko's ever, it's basically a place where you print out, you know, anything. You can print out documents, college papers, whatever, but you got to pay a little fee. Go in there, print out whatever you got to print out, and then bounce. I'm not sure if this is the place y'all go to print your stuff out in Germany, but now you guys probably have printing places too in Germany. I mean, you guys are pretty advanced, like super, super advanced, so I don't doubt it. The Mainz Cathedral. Ooh, this looks nice. Now, I'm not religious, but I'm definitely checking this out. All right, so Mainz Cathedral, or St. Martin's Cathedral, is located near the historical center and pedestrianized Market Square of the city of Mainz Center. So this 1,000-year-old Roman Catholic cathedral is the site of the Episcopal? I don't know how that. This Episcopal See of the Bishop of Mainz. Mainz Cathedral is predominantly Romanesque in style, but later exterior additions over many centuries have resulted in the appearance of various architectural influences seen today. It comprises three naves and stands under the patronage of Saint Martin of Tours. The entire choir is dedicated to Saint Stephen. Stephen, I don't know what y'all call him, man, but I'm gonna say Stephen for old time's sake. The interior of the cathedral houses tombs and funerary monuments of former powerful electoral prince archbishops. I don't know why this word is so, this word always gets me. Archbishops, or Kurfürst Erzbischof. I definitely did not say that right. Kurfürst Erzbischof of the diocese, and contains religious works of art spanning a millennium. The cathedral is also a central courtyard and statues of Saint Boniface and the Madonna and its grounds. During the time of the Mainz Archbishop Willigis, the city of Mainz flourished economically, and the Villages became the most influential. Villages became one of the most influential politicians of that time, ascending the regent of the empire between 991 and 994. Interesting. That was definitely a lot to get off my chest. Clearly, your boy has a reading problem. So, we gonna keep it pushing. Y'all can laugh. You know what I'm saying? All right. St. Stephen's Church. Y'all got a lot of nice churches out here, real talk. I want to see if I can take pictures in there. The collegiate Church of St. Stephen, known in German as the St. Stephen zu Mainz, is a Gothic hall collegiate church located in the German city of Mainz. It's known for windows created by Mark Chagall. You know what I'm saying? These windows be looking kind of sexy, though. I ain't gonna hold you, bro. Look at how nice these windows be looking, bro. Imagine if you were showering and you had windows like that. Oh my god, bro. Why would you be showering in the church is a real question, though. You know what I mean? So anyways, we keep it pushing. We move. Weingut Robert Weil. Ooh, I'm trying to see where the wine at, though, man. Where the wine at? Oh, hey! Weingut Robert Weil is a winery in Kiedrich, Germany. Bro, is this part of Mainz, though? Kiedrich, Germany, that's not no Mainz, right? That's not Mainz. That's Kiedrich. Unless Kiedrich is in Mainz. Y'all let me know, but I'm trying to drink some wine, bro. I'm trying to drink some goddamn wine. And I sip on that good wine. Rheinsteig. Ah, expansive hiking route with views. Ooh, you all know I like hiking. If you didn't know, now you do. All right. If you don't know, now you know. All right. Rheinsteig is a hiking trail following a mainly elevated path along the east bank of the Rhine River in Germany. Its 320-kilometer route stretches from Bonn to Wiesbaden, running parallel to the Rhine Hohenweg Trail, Hulenweg Trail, my bad, and Rheinbergenweg Trail. Interesting. Look at that. Okay. Look at the site. Okay. Look at. Nice. This is nice. This is nice. I'm not gonna hold you. This looks beautiful, bro. Imagine, like, oh my God, all the things I'm about to do out there in mines, bro, is about to be lit. Now I need y'all to let me know, real talk, what I should be doing out there. Corona kind of vitamin positive and befunden by mines. Oh no, somebody tested positive for corona in mines. Nine. Okay. Anyways, mines. Oh, this is the tourism website thing. Johannes Gutenberg Universität Mainz. Oh, they got the whole, like, uni named after Johannes Gutenberg? Oh, I believe it. I believe it. Oh, I believe it. So, in conclusion, Mainz is lit. Mainz is lit, okay? Mainz is lit, bro. It's lit. It is lit, bro. Okay. Neighborhoods is Mainz, Bretzenheim, Hartenberg, Münchfeld, Dreisberghof, Baumschule in Spetz. All right, that's tight. Well, ladies and gentlemen, boys and squirrels, that was a brief deep dive of Mainz, Germany. Hopefully you guys learned a lot. I know I did. I love you guys. Hopefully y'all love your boy, but if you don't, I understand. I'm not really a lovable person, but I did enjoy this video, and I want to see you guys in future videos. Let me know what you want me to do next. I should be vlogging. Problem with vlogging, though, is I don't know what to vlog, because I feel like my life is kind of boring, so I'm going to put together a random vlog, and hopefully you guys like that little thing, and I'll see you guys later. Take care. Love you guys. Peace. Well, what a pleasure it is to see all of your beautiful faces at the end of this lovely video.
Subscribe if you haven't already.
I'm sure you know, as I've mentioned in the past, we do have a Discord that's linked in the description down below, and we would love to have you a part of the world's greatest community ever. Bray Gang. Yes, if you've made it to this point in the video, you're officially a part of the community. So go ahead, join the Discord server. Link is in the description down below. And we also have other social media as well, like Instagram, Twitter. We're live. We go live on Twitch quite often as well. So it would behoove you to, you know, go ahead and subscribe to the Twitch channel at twitch.tv/JamesBrayGang. Join the cause and be a part of the greatest, literally the greatest community ever. Okay, it's simple. Just go ahead and do those little things. We're trying to grow on all these little platforms and everything, and it really means a lot. Now, I know you guys stumbled up across the channel and you're like, what does this guy post? Like, what kind of content does he post? Reactions, vlogs, pretty much whatever comes to my mind. All right, it's random content. I don't know what I'm gonna be posting 10 years from now, but I do know that you can stick along for the journey, and it really means a lot. Now, for every single person that subscribes and follows all of the accounts that I have made, and all the links will be in the description down below, that's an automatic entry for any future giveaways I decide to have. I'll remind you when the giveaways take place, but you'll be surprised what I will be giving away, because you guys have supported me so much up to this point, and it's only right that I do the same thing back. Thank you guys so much for being amazing, and I will see you in the next video. Take care. Peace.